Let us rise up at once and possess the land. Joshua and Caleb said, let's go up at once and possess it. We're well able. See, what happens when you step out of the natural in your pocketbook and step into God's pocketbook? When you stop reaching into your pocket and start reaching into God's pocket, when you start walking in His faith, which is beyond sight, and start walking in God's faith, when you start living in His health and His wisdom and His joy, all of a sudden, things that were impossible become possible. This is the life of faith and the promises of God. The more you release your faith to go to work for you, the more you see in here that you can believe God for. See, there's just no limit. Jesus kept saying, all things are possible to them that believe. Well, let me finish this letter. A brand new car, the first one we'd ever had. Last and most important of all is the overwhelming love of the Lord that I feel. See, that was in the same last letter, this love. See, when people begin to see God answer their prayer, it just ministers to them. See, but a lot of times, some preachers don't preach this level of faith, and consequently, the people have a hard time receiving from God. Because without faith, it's impossible to please from God. Last and most important of all is the overwhelming love of the Lord that I feel. He has given me a love that I never even known. Sometimes this love overwhelms me so much that all I can do is cry. And I'm not normally an emotional person. My pockets are never empty, but most important of all, neither is my heart. Thank you, and praise be to Jesus, our Lord and Savior, your friend in Christ. My husband now tithes off the top of his paychecks. Praise the Lord. See, Malachi 3 says, God said, you're robbing me. God said, you're robbing me. You are robbing me with your tithes and offerings. They said, how have we robbed you? He says, with your tithes and offerings. He said, prove me now herewith, your tithes and offerings, and see if I will not open, I love that word, open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that there is not room enough to receive them all. Now, I didn't say that. God said that. And the more you believe that and act upon it with your faith, the more that will happen in your life. These are just two of many, many letters that we're receiving. Look at all of these prayer of agreement, prayer requests that are coming in and people asking for prayer cloths. Odessa, Texas, Mount Vernon, New York, Fort Worth, Texas, Charlotte, North Carolina, Clarksdale, Mississippi, Berkeley Springs, West Virginia, Lumberton, North Carolina, Verkuk, Wisconsin, Canada, California, Philadelphia, Tulsa, Monticello, Detroit, Firebar, California, just from all over the place, Jamaica, New York, Louisiana. People are writing in and are calling in, and they're getting their prayer request in, and miracles are happening. God said, my house shall be called a house of prayer. I want you to watch this lady here. She had a terrible time in her legs and in her knees and walking. The doctors had done all they could do, but God healed her. Right after that, we've got some special announcements, so don't go away. I believe God's going to minister to you some more.
Cast the Lord's salt into your bitter waters of life and receive God's sweet miracle of restoration. Return your prayer request today.
People all over are discovering God's miracle plan for man, and it's making a difference in their lives. Discover the joy of this message when you call area code 214-620-6200. God's Miracle Plan for Man by Robert Tilton. Call for your free copy today.
I do not come with a word from America, but I come this afternoon with a word from God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth has sent me here to tell you that you can walk.
To God through Robert Tilton Ministries, we continue to reach the world with a message of hope. He gives seed to sow, bread to eat, multiplies and increases fruit. 2 Corinthians 9:10.
Who has some kind of a broken bone that will not heal? A broken bone that will not heal. I want you to stand up real quickly, whoever you are. A broken bone that will not heal. Come here, sister. Thank you, Jesus. Where do you have a bone that won't heal?
My knee. I had 9 operations on it. And my bones, did I say my bones deteriorating? And I have been trying to walk in faith without my cane and stuff. And it just won't seem to heal. They say there's nothing they can do about it.
It just won't seem to heal. Nothing that doctors say they can do about it.
Right.
Well, I'll tell you, Dr. Jesus can do something about it. There's not anything Dr. Jesus cannot do. Well, this sister's being healed right now in her knee. When I grabbed a hold of her, I saw a special miracle start moving in her knee. God making the bones whole and healing that knee. Thank you, Lord, for Holy Ghost surgery on this knee. Holy Ghost surgery on this knee. Let's get this little sister up here. She looks like she's drunk. Now bend your knee around. Bend your knee around. Bend that knee around. Bend that knee around. Bend it. Bend it. Bend it around. Bend it around. Hallelujah. Bend that knee. Bend that knee. Okay. How's that? Kicked her shoes off and started dancing. You dance too. God just healed your knee and the doctor said they couldn't do nothing about it. Let's give her and Jesus a big praise God.
It's so exciting to see the Spirit of God heal people and make people whole. Several months ago, one evening, I was meditating in God's Word, thinking about it, pondering it in my mind. 2 Corinthians 5:21, Him who knew no sin, Jesus, was made to be sin or bore the effects of our mistakes in His own body so that we could become the very righteousness of God in Christ. And as I was pondering that in my heart, I've been doing that for several days, all of a sudden, the reality of being totally clean and released from all condemnation and brought into right wise and agreement and pureness and cleanness in the presence of God. Righteousness brings the presence of God into your life. God withdraws Himself from uncleanness, but He makes His presence known when a person is clean and released from the effects of sin. And then I saw a crowd, a line of people as far as I could see, and the Lord spoke to me and He said, as I was in His presence, see, I saw righteousness brings the presence of God and brings you into the presence of God. Can you imagine? The presence of God, nothing is impossible. There's just, it was perfect peace. It was just perfect joy, perfect love. It was like I was a new person. It was like I was another person. It was like I was not anywhere close to that old man, that old nature, that old feeling that always was pressed down. It's like all this pressing down stuff was gone. I was standing tall and everything was just easy. And He said, I want you to pray the prayer of agreement with my people. And I began to agree with people in front of me. And they had every kind of problem imaginable. And as I began to agree with them in prayer, Matthew 18:19, it was as easy as breathing. Miracles began to happen all over the place. And it went into my spirit man, a level of faith for agreeing with people. And that's what I'm doing. These people right here have all written in their prayer request and the needs that they have right here. And I'm laying my hands upon them and agreeing with people and sending back these red prayer cloths. Before I go any further, I want to send you. See, I put together this package. I sat down. See, I like things to be written and visible, visuals. I put this package together. And in this package, I have a letter that I explained to you, the prayer of agreement, this vision that I had, and that I ministered to you in this letter on how to receive from God. And then I have a special book on God's miracle plan for man. And when God visited me and showed me how to break the curse of lack off of people. You see, God gave me these things. He said, freely receive and freely give. God gave me these truths, opened my eyes. Remember Elijah's servant? And he was so upset because they were surrounded by the enemy. And Elijah wasn't upset at all. And he said, Lord, open his eyes that he may see that there is more that be with us than be with the enemy. And his eyes were opened. And he saw the chariots of fire and the horsemen of Israel. And he saw the armies of God.